The howl of the wolf is the soundtrack of wilderness. And wilderness, the ferment of the soul. Primal humans knew what modern humanity has forgotten, that life is balance. The world endlessly consuming itself and joyously making love to itself through its constituent parts. Every species equal with an inherent intrinsic value, sacred worth, sacred worth. Civilization is a mere 16,000 year imbalance after the shared adventure of 3.5 billion years of ecstatic evolution. Now called deep ecology, this sacred worldview was the life and practice of all primitive peoples. And it will be the worldview once again of any peoples to survive the Earth's cataclysmic cleansing. Based on balance, began with the great conservationist Aldo Leopold. But it was a lesson written in blood. It was an enchanted New Mexico morning when Leopold, then a young timber cruiser for the fledgling Forest Service, rode his spotted horse up over the divide. Captured by the beauty of the tree-lined mountains of the Gila, Leopold was surprised by familiar-looking impressions in the damp ground below. They were the tracks of something familiar. They were the tracks of something wilder than we are. They were the tracks of a wolf, a wolf, a wolf. Then, suddenly, he noticed the darting shapes below. Gray blurs running across the steamy bog. Running with the wind, running for their lives. Running with the wind, running for their lives. Running, 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 and running, and running, and running, and running. And Aldo had been taught, that wolves eat deer and elk. And so we imagined that if there were no wolves, it would be deer and elk everywhere. A hunter's paradise, paradise. And so Leopold, known as the father of deep ecology, did what any red-blooded American male in his day and age would have done. And he pulled the rifle from his scabbard. And he pulled the rifle gently against his shoulder. And he leaned down over the sights. And he pointed at those dancing shapes below. And slowly but surely, Aldo Leopold pulled the trigger. The old wolf tumbled in the mud and snow below. Her last breaths billowing out like clouds in the sky. Slowly, Aldo rode up and dismounted, and he walked up to where the she-wolf lay. And then, for the briefest moment, she stared up into his eyes, locked eyes with his. And there in the middle, was a fire. Not just the golden fire of life, but also a green fire. The green fire of the last old growth. The green fire of the last undammed river. The green fire of wilderness, wilderness, wilderness. And Aldo Leopold knew then and there that there could be no real wilderness without the wolf, and no real wild without that green fire inside of us. And slowly, ever so slowly, she closed her eyes, and the old wolf died. And a little piece of Aldo died with that wolf. But also, a little piece of that wolf lived on inside of Aldo Leopold's soul. And a little piece of that wolf lives on inside the spirits and the souls of the last wild people, the last tribe, dancing, dancing, and dancing, the dance of resistance. Running out over the bogs, running out over the mesas, running out of the mountains, running free, running wild, running free, running wild, running free, running wild. Never stop howling!